Let me just go back to this digital aspect, because the only thing that bothers me is the fact, what is real anymore? When you look at a photograph, what is real?
Very
if
little.
You can just drop things in.
Well, we got used to it in films, you know, with computer-generated stuff. I think that we have to accept now that photography does lie. I can make people look exactly like I want. I can stretch them. I can put them anywhere I want. We had a case not long ago where I had to shoot last weekend. A couple of weekends ago, I was shooting Isabella Rossellini in New York, and they wanted her walking through Times Square at midnight. And I figured that that would be difficult, dangerous, and create a security problem. So I went out and did Times Square in the middle of the night without her, because there were no lights or any problems like that. Shot her the next day on a piece of pavement that resembled Times Square. Put the two together, and you'll never know that she wasn't there.
Magic.
Well, it saves me a fortune if you think about going on trips with expensive models, when in fact you don't have to do that anymore.
But then there'd be no gossip about you at all, Patrick. Well, now that you don't take any models away whatsoever.
That would save me a lot of trouble.
So let me get the picture then. So you go off to those deserted beaches and you
do
the
shots. With a muscular assistant, yes.
And you keep all the models back in England.
Precisely so. And then you just simply put them on the studio roof at exactly the same time of the day. Doesn't matter which latitude you're in. You've got to have more or less the same weather conditions. And zap them in. And that's easy. I mean, it's not a real problem. So you save airfares, hairdressers, makeup, stylists, drivers, assistants.
You can add it to your fee. It's
yeah,
all terrific.
Of course you can, yes.
So now, who did you take? You've got a place in Mystique.
Yes, that's
and
right.
And I know you sometimes do some shoots there. So who have you taken there of late?
Well, I was just doing a wonderful Romanian girl for an American magazine doing a lot of swimwear, which we did do digitally, but although, of course, we did take the girl with us because she actually had to be lying across black rocks.
So it's you can't drop in anybody
you
and you can't drape them over rocks.
Just as easy and more fun to go there. Anyway, what I wanted to show off, though, was that there were two other photographers working alongside me, and they were clutching their little bags of film at the end, and we went away from there knowing we had every picture on our computer, no worries about the going through the customs and all the rest of it.
So do you never use film at all now?
I haven't for 3 years, no.
Really? So it's revolutionised. So, in other words, you can touch up any face, do anything?
Oh, we can make people look absolutely wonderful, I promise you.
Digital's for me from here on in, I tell you. Marvellous.
What you can do is, I mean, you can go take this to extremes. For example, if somebody wanted cosmetic surgery, they only have to come into the studio and we can do it for them and then they can show it to the surgeon.
And see what they want
exactly.
to look like.
Exactly.
Gosh, that's a good idea. Is it true that you have 4 million photographs in your archive?
Well, it is. I think it is. I've been looking through them recently because I've got a display at the National Portrait Gallery coming up in May next year of the first 20 years of my photography, which I started on October the 14th, 1962 at 2:30. And here we are. 2 months later, 2 months after 40 years. So I've been going now for 40 years and 2 months.
How are you ever going to sift through 4 million?
It's terribly difficult. Oh. I get bored after about 10 photographs.
And you obviously have all those catalogued.
Well, we do, but on the other hand, it's just digitally, it would be so much easier to do. But what we now do is we have to go through all those contact sheets and look through each one and see if we can find something good.
Patrick, it's always a joy to talk to you.